Evening all, now respawns, hope you're doing well. So we're back in the airport for another Brotherhood of Steel themed build. Now this is a barracks, but it's an awfully weird looking barracks, which I love. I absolutely love this. This is so strange because, so in the one of the recent updates, we, for the unlocks and objects mod, as you can see, we've got slightly more modular elements of these capsules. Those who remember, for my Brotherhood of Steel player home, I use this as the basis for the build. Now the reason being, just to kind of remind everyone why I'm doing this, is that I wanted my Brotherhood Steel builds to kind of follow a certain aesthetic where they don't look too scrappy and, like, at best things look kind of modular. Because don't forget, you know, this is a military setup. These guys, you know, they're not just going to shove corrugated steel together. They're actually going to put a bit more effort, or at least just have the mechanisms in place to maybe make something a bit more portable, especially with the Pridwin really nearby. You know, they can have this ship packed up and ready to go. However, that did present a little bit of problems in kind of making my buildings look unique and weird and just kind of trying to distinguish them. So this is a barracks, but I've kind of gone a bit weird. And there are lots of parts in this where you're like, yeah, but why? And I'm like, well, why not? It looks cool. I'm like, yeah, but why though? you'll see in a wee bit. But I love it. Like, the whole outcome is, like, the whole end result is very, very cool. It was quite easy to decorate as well because it's kind of, it's quite cramped. I'm really, really pleased with this one. So what I've gone and done is I've got this, there are two new ones added. So there's that kind of longer capsule piece, and then there's the smaller ones, and there's the mid one. So I want to use the mid one, I wanted to use the smaller ones, and I wanted to connect them in a kind of like unconventional way. So what I ended up doing, initially I was going to have it behind, and you'll see in a second, I do leave it in. I use one of the, basically, spoiler, I'm going to have like a little ramp, like a little walkway going through that big one and this little one. However, I try and play around a little bit, and I decide to leave my experimentation in a little bit. A quick note, as you can see, these come with these little kind of modular doorway wall bits as well. Now, they're really, really difficult to get in. If you can actually technically kind of manually place them, but it's quite difficult to get them very, very close. So I tend to find it's just easier just to put the, use the pillar to move them in. However, you're probably going to see, because I have to redo quite a few, is there a bit of, it's really hard to gauge whether they're completely, because if they're not completely bang center, they just look really stupid and weird. So it's just kind of worth pointing that out. It's a bit of a pain, but you know, as long as you're not doing like, you know, dozens upon dozens of these things, you're probably doing fine. I think I do in a wee bit, in a minute, do I? Maybe not. It's sometimes easier to grab the pillar and then kind of stand in the inside and do it that way. But I think I do show it. If not, you'll have to just manage and figure it out, I guess. It's quite simple. It's just a pain in the ass. So this is the part I changed my mind on. So initially, I was just kind of, I don't know why I did this, because I already vaguely knew what I was going to do. I just thought, I'm going to experiment. So I wasted loads of my time doing this. So I wanted kind of a pointless platform. Now the whole idea is, what I end up doing, spoiler, is this is a walkway and we end up having the kind of chain link fences on the outside. It's just kind of, it just looks weird, but it's cool and it weirdly works. But I decided to just kind of fuck around and see what these are. It's quite an interesting technique and I'm going to try and fiddle around with this. I've still got one more structure to build in this airport, but I'm probably going to have to do a few more of the Brotherhood of Steel quests because I'm pretty sure I need some of the space. But I just like, it's one of the reasons, one of the ways, for those who don't know, like, someone asked me how I get some ideas from, I kind of get my ideas from doing things like this. So I'll be building something like this, and then I'll just kind of like go, that could work. It doesn't work at all. It's a terrible idea what I tried to do. Not terrible, actually, I just, what I end up doing is significantly better and a little bit weirder. Oh, it is weird, though. It is weird, but it works. In the words of the great Todd, it just works. So yeah, see, obviously with that random little thing there, and that's the entrance, by the way. So that looks bollocks. We don't like that. Now what I can do with this is just move it in there with the concrete pillar. Oh, ho, ho, ho. This place is really coming together. I even have a dog, and his name is Chubbs. I know that because those who don't know, I just like to remind people because it's a cool little thing that loads of people don't know you can do. If you have the Far Harbor DLC, there is somewhere a crashed plane with maybe a fellow who sells you guard dogs, among other things, and they replenish every few days. Which is why all my settlements now have a guard dog in, and they're all named. So this one was called... Was it called Chubbs? Or was it called Bubba? No, it's called Chubbs. Damn it, I made sure to pay attention to the name. Yeah, it was Chubbs. His name's Chubbs. So there we go. There's a nice dog named Chubbs. Top lad is Chubbs. Though he is a little bit on his lonesome right now, so I should probably get him some kind of friend. Now, I'm not actually sure. I think I can send people here. Because I've got a load of mods. I think there's a mod that allows me to send people here. I have no idea. So if not, we might not actually end up having any settlers here at all. Oh well, at least I got a home for them. I'm going to have a robot here, though. So as you can see right here, so I've basically just plopped this in here. I had to move, as you saw before, I had to move the smaller capsule back to make sure I can fit this mesh fence in. This works so well. Like, this looks really cool, but it's pointless. It's pointless. It just looks cool, yeah? That's basically it. It's just a pointless thing that I thought, ooh, that looks cool, and it does. I'm really pleased. Yes. So my whole idea was I was thinking of, kind of, you know, when you get, I've never been in the army, but I've obviously watched TV and films, so it's close enough, right? But, you know, in kind of military encampments where they have kind of the barracks, and then they have that kind of little kind of social eating area, you know, where they're all sitting down eating their trays and shit like that. So kind of like that was kind of what I wanted, but on a kind of smaller scale. So it's just kind of like, you've got the barracks, you've got where they keep the lockers. I just wanted to have this again. I don't need to use... I love this ramp, it's so good. But yeah, like, there's going to be like another canopy to mirror my house. My capsule thing. And it's going to look pretty cool. It's going to look pretty cool. So I'm pillar glitching here, and I don't actually need to do that. Because also, you notice that pallet is sticking into the ground, so I can actually just do that. Oh, so good. I love this. People pointed out they don't know if the NPCs actually use these ramps a lot. Don't care. Look cool. Don't give a shit. It looks grand, so I don't give a fuck. It's good. So this is where I'm just kind of like thinking of ideas. Now, I wasn't too sure. And I eventually, because I wanted to have it so you could kind of see in this. That was the whole idea. What I ended up landing on, pretty pleased. Because the cool thing is, I just had to show you my thought process, because I was like, is, yeah, these have been added now, so kind of like parts of the, these are from the actual main wall barriers, but they've just kind of taken them off. So what I ended up doing is landing on is one of these in front. Trust me, this looks really weird, right? When I'm making this, you're like, that looks nothing like barracks, David. That's fucking ridiculous. But trust in me, yeah? Trust Davey. I vaguely, slightly know what I'm doing. I don't. I'm lying. I'm making it as I go along, as you can see. But it works. So there we go. There's method to my madness, vaguely. So I put these little concrete bits on the edge. It all looks really weird. Strangest barracks ever, but it just works. I love it. I love it because when I'm doing, because I've made so many videos now, I make a huge effort, I hope you notice, of making most builds unique in some way. And you probably gathered already, after 220 videos, it's sometimes a little bit difficult. But it's actually not, it just involves thinking outside the box. So I always think, oh god, I can't think of anything, then I go for a period where I can think of weird shit. So I'm just assuming there are ideas, there probably are ideas forever, and I'm grand. I can rehash all our old ideas if I nearly need to, kind of modernize them, which is what I'm gonna start doing. But yes, look at this. Look at it. Looks so cool. It looks completely different when I decorate it, by the way. You is gonna be proper's impressed, yeah. I don't know why I'm talking like that. What's wrong with me? I don't know. Right, so we're grabbing the roof here. The reason why I'm pillar glitching the roof is because I was gonna sink it together and make it. It actually looks pretty cool as well underneath. I made a point. It's a bit difficult to put in, as you can see. Ba 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 ba. Gorgeous. Vaguely get that, use the scaffolding, because we need something a wee bit higher than I was using before. Come on, love. Come on. There we go. Yes, so there we go. And I think the next building, I don't know what it's going to be, but it'll be something probably not using the capsules, because I think I've got my two capsule areas. I need something a bit different now, like a third building, but I don't know when that'll be. I've quite enjoyed making the airport. I never thought the airport would look like this. And I'm quite chuffed with how everything's turned out and kind of the theme I didn't think I'd enjoy making Brotherhood of Steel building so much. Anyway, there we go. Tor in a second. Voila. There's Chubbs. He's just monging around. There are actually invisible rugs where he sits on that little rug there, but there's like an invisible rug in the Unlock Settlement Objects mod you can place. So we go. Here's the kind of, you know, it's hanging out. I should really got them a deck of cards if I could have found one. I don't think there is, but I'll have a look. Food for Chubbs, another little workstation area. This whole area just works. Like, it's weird, but it's like, oh, that actually looks pretty cool. I'm really surprised. Got the lockers, and then the inside of the actual barracks area is quite cramped, but I like it. And this area, completely pointless. Little walkway, but it looks cool. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed that. As always, follow me on Twitter at norespawns if you'll see them up to. If you'll see me tweet out little spoilerific videos of what I'm doing, I do that a lot before I upload. Definitely follow me at norespawns. You guys enjoy your week, and I'll talk to you lovely people soon. You take care.